Hi friends, I'm Crystal Bessie of the Louisiana Farm to School program. This month's Louisiana Harvest of the Month never backs down from a fight, always raising its claws, holding its ground instead. It's even honored as the totem of the native Houma people for its courage and resilience. It's crawfish. This savory crustacean was of great importance to the original peoples in Louisiana, all the way back to their origin story. For Louisianans today, crawfish is woven into our culture and traditions. Today, I'm in Roanoke, Louisiana at Tallgrass Farms to learn more about how this tiny creature makes such a big splash in Louisiana aquaculture. Although people have always eaten them, crawfish were first commercially harvested from the Atchafalaya Basin starting around 1880. Before that, most crawfish were caught wild. When the river or bayou waterways would flood, all you needed was a pole with some bait. Thanks to growing popularity, the Louisiana crawfish industry began to soar over the last few decades. Rice farmers, looking to boost their income when the rice prices declined, began to reflood their fields after the rice harvest to farm crawfish in the off-season. Today, more than 1,500 farmers collectively harvest nearly 86,000 tons of crawfish each year from February to May. I'm here with Burt, Tietje of Tallgrass Farm. Burt has a 460-acre rice and crawfish farm, and today he's going to show us the crawfish's habitat and harvesting process. So Burt, let's go back to the beginning. Tell me about how you got into farming in the first place.
Well, I've been on the farm all my life. This is my grandfather's farm. He settled here about 1890, thereabouts. We've been growing rice on the farm ever since. About 26, 27 years ago, I started doing crawfish on the farm. Year after year, crawfish rice, crawfish rice.
Rice is planted in March. When the rice crop is tall enough around May, flooded fields are stocked with mature crawfish. Once the rice is ready to be harvested around the end of July, fields are drained and the crawfish instinctively bury into the ground where it's cool, and they stay there until the fall. In October, ponds are reflooded and crawfish emerge from their burrows with several hundred babies attached to the tail of the mothers. Beginning in January, fields are flooded to about 2 feet of water. Crawfish are then harvested and brought to market where the catch will peak in April and May, and the cycle continues. Let's talk about the actual crawfish. Can we look at one?
This particular variety is called the red swamp crawfish that we have here. It's called Precambrius clarkii is the Latin name for it. And this is what has the beautiful tail meat that everybody associates with Louisiana crawfish.
So are there male and female crawfish, and how can you tell the difference?
There definitely are. I've got a female crawfish here. She's got a little dot between her legs there. That's where she lays her eggs, which she gathers on her tail. When we pump up the old rice field to become a crawfish pond, she's going to emerge from that burrow with anywhere from 300 to 700 eggs cupped on her tail.
Oh, wow.
So they are tiny, tiny. Take about 4 months for an egg to become a marketable size crawfish.
Do crawfish molt?
Yes, crawfish molt. When a crawfish gets too big for its shell, it's got no way to grow because it's got this hard shell made out of calcium, just like your bones on the outside of the shell, an exoskeleton. So when it gets too big for the shell, it secretes a hormone which begins to draw the calcium out of the shell. And the shell becomes softer and softer and softer until the crawfish can finally muscle up out of that soft shell. He's bigger, and now he's got to reabsorb all that calcium so he hardens up the shell again. That molting is going to happen at least 11 times from the time they're a tiny egg to the time they're a marketable sized crawfish.
So do you do anything to feed the crawfish?
Not a thing. This is a completely natural process. We put water on our old rice field and nature does everything else.
So can you tell me about the benefits of how does the crawfish and rice work together? What are those benefits?
The beautiful thing about rice and crawfish in rotation is the crawfish uses all the infrastructure that we normally use, that we had been using for our rice crops for years. So it was a natural to go from rice to crawfish. So let me tell you about the trap.
Yeah.
Everybody in the industry is using a trap pretty similar to this. There's three holes in the trap we call funnels. This is how the crawfish get into the trap. We put a piece of stinky bait in the top of the trap. They smell that oily fish. They crawl all over this trap until they finally find one of these funnels and they get in. And they just stay there. They're not very smart.
Okay, well, I think from here, after you get lots of sacks out of the pond, we move on to the processing facility. But before we do that, let's go over to Judy and see what she's got cooking up in the kitchen.
Can't wait.
Hello, I'm Judy Myhan from LSU, and here we are at a crawfish farm. It's so beautiful here. So crawfish is actually low in fat. Crawfish tails, loosely packed into a cup, weigh 5 ounces and supply about 100 kilocalories. Most of those calories come from protein. So Burt, how do you cook your crawfish?
I'm a little different from most people. Most people in Louisiana, there are 4 million people and there are 4 million recipes for boiling crawfish. And I don't boil crawfish, I steam them. And what I like about the way I do it is I taste the crawfish meat.
Right.
Much more than
the seasoning and all that.
The seasoning is not what is so important to me, the flavor of the crawfish.
We came up with some recipes for crawfish that take advantage of that wonderful flavor. Really easy to prepare in the classroom. So using some Louisiana rice and seasonings, we created a wonderful 4-ingredient Cajun crawfish rice that can be easily prepared in an Instant Pot. You can peel your own crawfish or buy it frozen. Remove the bag of frozen crawfish and set it in the refrigerator, though, overnight to thaw. First thing that we do is we saute our trinity, our vegetables that are onions and celery and bell pepper. And then we add, after we've sauteed it a little bit in some butter, we're gonna add rice, the crawfish, and our seasoning and cook it. It takes about 10 minutes when you're using white rice in the Instant Pot. And then you're going to cook it for about 10 minutes, then do the quick release, and you have beautiful crawfish rice. Would you like to try some?
I would.
All right.
It all sounds good to me. You did a good job, Judy.
All right, very
good.
And
now we're on the edge of a crawfish pond.
That's right.
Good job.
That's right. We're good. We've got some skills. So why don't you go and catch up with Crystal? We're going to show one more recipe here, and I'll see you later.
Thank you.
Really,
we're going to show you how to we get the crawfish to market.
Okay.
Thank you, Judy.
Very good. Thank you. Now we're going to prepare the crawfish dip or filling, and you can do this in a microwave oven or in an Instant Pot, which we're going to use today. To make it savory, we added garlic and chopped vegetables, and some seasonings, like some Cajun seasoning, smoked paprika, delicious crawfish, and pimentos. We are gonna saute the chopped vegetables in a little butter to start with, and then we're going to add the rest of the ingredients and cook it in the Instant Pot. Now, while that's cooking, I'm going to show you what we like to do with the crawfish dip. We can use it as a filling. So we can take pie crust that you can buy in the grocery store. I find mine in the dairy section. I roll it out, and then I use about a 4-inch cutter to cut little circles to use to make the crawfish hand pies. Place a little dip on the side. Fold it over like that. Pinch it, and then bake it in the toaster oven. And those recipes are on the Seeds to Success website if you want to give them a try. We love to eat crawfish, but did you ever wonder what crawfish like to eat in the wild? They dine on insects and something called zooplankton, which are little tiny waterborne aquatic animals. And because of this diet, they're likely to avoid contamination with minerals. And speaking of minerals, crawfish are a good source of minerals like iron, calcium, and potassium that are essential minerals that are often low in the American diet. So, eat more crawfish.
Here we are at I-10 Crawfish. We followed the crawfish just a short distance down the road to the processing facility. And so this is where the crawfish is going to be cleaned, sorted, and packaged for distribution.
Crawfish farmers like Burt bring and sell their catch to processing facilities like this one for marketing and distribution. The mesh bags they deliver contain crawfish in a mixture of sizes straight from the pond. Those bags are called field run. The facility sells these field run bags to customers without washing or grading them. Crawfish destined for markets such as restaurants are washed before moving into a machine grader where a conveyor system sorts them by size. The larger crawfish are then bagged and placed in a cooler ready for distribution. But what about those small crawfish? Because none of the crop is wasted, smaller crawfish will move on to a handling and cooking facility like Bocage Crawfish.
Okay, so I'm here with Alan Lawson, and he's one of the owners of Bocage Crawfish, and you guys kind of bring in some of the smaller but still profitable crawfish into your facility.
Right. When the crawfish come out of the field, the crawfish that are not marketable, restaurant size, restaurant quality crawfish, will come to a facility like this and become tail meat. So what we'll do is we'll take in that smaller crawfish, we'll peel it and we'll pack it in a 1 pound bag that you'll find in a grocery store.
Okay.
Now that you know what we sell and what we do, let's go take a walk and I'll show you how we do it.
I would love to see that.
Okay,
thank you.
Good.
We start out at the steamer, where the crawfish are brought upon arrival. They are steam cooked and then chilled down quickly afterwards, where workers are waiting to peel them. Next, the meat is weighed out into 1 pound packages, which are frozen and prepared for retail sale.
It takes about 6.5 pounds of live crawfish to make a pound of tail meat. Most of the peeling women will peel 5 or 6 pounds an hour. Some of them will get up to 10 pounds an hour. And a sack's
and a
about
package.
Between 30 and 35 pounds. And we also pack a whole cooked crawfish. We cook it the same way we would cook this, but instead of peeling it, we'll put it in a bag and it'll go to your buffets and retail, and you'll be able to enjoy as close to fresh of a crawfish out of season.
Right, so it's a whole intact crawfish.
Whole intact crawfish, yeah. Right.
Well, thank you so much for having us today. I really appreciate your hospitality and letting me get my hands dirty a little bit.
Okay, well, come back when you're ready to peel some crawfish anytime.
Okay, thanks.
The Louisiana Harvest of the Month program showcases a different Louisiana-grown food each month in Louisiana communities. We hope you will join us in tasting Louisiana this month.
Support provided by the Louisiana Ag in the Classroom program, giving educators the tools to increase understanding of agriculture and renewable food, fiber, and fuel systems. Learn more at aitcla.org. And by the Louisiana Department of Health, working to improve disparities in healthcare and health outcomes. Information at ldh.la.gov.